What's up, everyone? How's everyone going? Game Buckle, and ladies and gentlemen, we are playing Mafia 3. Let's do this, everyone. Good series. We're going to do this all along. A couple of years are coming out. Let's do this. Let's get the series done. Let's have some fun. The storyline's good. We're going to do this. This is our time. Let's go. I had to put the sound off because it's copyright. Sorry, you can't really hear it. I can.
And take in its natural splendor.
Sour Cano had no idea what he was going to unleash.
New Bordeaux. Safe. Family-oriented farm. Make it your next vacation destination.
This city survived the War of 1812, the Civil War, and God knows how many hurricanes. But when Lincoln Clay went after the mob, he inflicted more damage than all the wars and hurricanes combined.
Lincoln's mother abandoned him in 1947, a couple of years after he was born. His mother, I heard she was Dominican. I always figured his father's white, maybe not Italian. Not that it mattered. Back then, if you look black, you black. Same as today, I suppose. He stayed at the orphanage until 1958.
Now, when did you meet Lincoln Clay?
1966. I was running Black Ops at Laos on behalf of the CIA. He was loaned out to me via joint CIA DOD task force.
He was a quiet boy. Good boy.
Two Purple Hearts, a Bronze Star, and the Distinguished Service Cross. He served his country with honor and distinction.
After the city closed the orphanage, he fell in with Sammy Robinson. Sammy ran the black mob over in Delray Hollow. I can't say I approve, but often colored boys didn't have a lot of options back then. Boys like Lincoln, ones who've been abandoned, they're always looking for a home. Always looking for a place to belong. I think he thought he'd find it NAMI. Thing is, once that's lost, you can never get it back again. When he returned from the war, Lincoln ended back up over at Sammy's. Now, Sammy owed the Italian mob a whole lot of money, and he needed Lane's help. It's a damn shame what happened. It breaks my heart.
Thank you. still say this is the craziest goddamn thing I ever heard. Use real money to rob the feds.
Well, hell, man, not like this is our cash. This all came from Skeletta. Besides, peanuts compared to what we're gonna haul out of there.
Is everything we need to burn?
Yeah, that's it. I grab the keys to the truck, then we can get the fuck out of here.
Okay. Ready to get out of here.
Keys in another room. Grab them so we can get the hell out of here.
Okay. Here we go. No? Oh, shit. Okay.
And grab those keys.
Okay.
Still not sure about leaving him like this.
He came through with the truck, just like we asked. The greatest partner to make it look good. But if you got doubts, why take the chance? Lincoln, pick up the keys.
Sorry, I wanna bring him. Come on, I want to bring this guy. Here you are. Merry Christmas. Right there. Have a nice day. You stay there. Have a nice day. You be a good boy, okay? I know it's a bit scary, but oh my god, dude, seriously. Don't care, dude. Seriously. Calm down. Don't get angry at me. Don't. It's okay. Calm down. Good boy.
We should get going. You got the keys so you can drive.
Come on, let's get the hell out of here.
Good. What? No, you sound like... Oh, I'm not gonna say it. I have a problem.
Come on, man, we don't have time for this shit.
Harry,
we need to roll.
Jump. Oh.
Come on, Lincoln, we burning daylight.
How do you jump? Okay. Right there. Right there. Instructions. 2K, that's what they are.
You get a move on. Let's go.
I don't know why. Right there.
Stop fucking around.
All right then, that's that.
Got. Let's go, man. The clock's ticking.
Ah, sorry. Driving my car. Wonder is,
take it easy heading to town. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses. My old man wanted us to keep one of the guards alive, help throw the feds off the trail.
Like you said, I take a chance. Besides, if I learn anything from being over in Nam, someone's willing to flip sides once, they're probably willing to do it a second time.
Don't you beep at me!
So answer me this. What's the craziest thing you saw over there?
You don't want to know.
Hey, man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Oh, Georgie Marcano pays taxes.
Damn right I do. That's how they got Al Capone, and I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill. Huh. Come on, you going to answer the question or what?
We on the coast of Quang Nai, evacuating the civvies before Charlie overran everything. Anyway, we getting them onto a medical ship, and this woman walks up. She got a baby in one hand and the leash to a pig in the other. She starts up the ramp and the MP stops her and tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby into the water. MP goes ape, tells someone dive in after the kid, starts screaming at the woman, wants to know what the fuck she's thinking. You know what she says to him? She says, I can always have another baby.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Hey man, you asked.
Yeah, but I thought you were gonna tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, god damn.
It's not a fault. But not like you think. The conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day you're raising cattle, tending your rice. Next day everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall, they will do anything to survive.
That better have been one delicious fucking pig.
It's really good game, I think.
The
gameplay's really good.
I think,
like, a bit of GTA.
75.
Oh,
what
fuck,
are you doing?
Sorry. I'm fucking sorry. Pass my language, everyone, but...
Guys at the reserve probably won't be too keen on you walking Sorry. Around with that piece of yours.
I'll just leave it under the seat.
Cops are gonna notice us if you're running people over.
Did I run somebody over, everyone? Did I? Comment, please, on this conversation.
Time to see if these forged IDs are worth a fuck.
Back it up to the loading dock.
It's like that heist in GTA, the final, I think it's Finance.
Some of these fellas might get a little rough with the language and...
Well, I ain't like I never been called nigga before.
Nah, I know, but I'm just saying, if I go along with it, nothing personal.
The only thing I care about is getting our money.
When I say something about being hot, that's when we make our move.
All right.
Where the hell you going, Lincoln?
Oh, here we go.
Put your IDs up to the glass.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
What the fuck's this shit heel doing here?
Affirmative action. You know how it is.
Old country is spinning around a goddamn toilet. You can follow me. As for you, go on and grab those bags off the truck. You'll be carrying them to the burning room. How much y'all bring in?
$238,546. Mostly.
I'll have Miss Gale call up to your office when we're done. She'll confirm the delivery.
Appreciate it.
You need to check that scatter gun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
You can pick it up on way out.
Burn room's down in the cellar. This way. I ain't seen y'all around these parts before.
Y'all's over in Georgia for a while. Mm-hmm. He just got out the service.
Yeah! My cousin's been trying to get on here for over a year now. Was in the Navy for two tours, got medals falling out of his ass. Government tells him thanks, but no thanks.
That's a crock of shit if I ever heard one.
Sad day when a God-fearing white man can't get a job. It ain't your nigga who staggers in his hide on the spot.
Hmm?
You bastards better not be playing with each other back there.
Fuck you!
Christ, look at that. Didn't know y'all held that much gold.
Yeah, Washington's been shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, then it gets sent to Dallas, then it comes back. Yeah, it doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense. Here we are. Put those bags on the table there.
Never done this detail before. Figured it'd be bigger.
It gets the job done. Only time there's a problem is when the flue clogs up.
Fuck, that's some heat right there.
We used to use coal for it, but a year or so back we switched over to oil. Maintains a more consistent flame.
Here's some guy come around the house trying to switch me over to oil. Told him I wasn't interested. God, that guy was an asshole.
We need to move. Danny and Ellis should be coming up any time now.
All right, give me a second. All right, you take care of those guards. Keep your ass down. You don't want them getting a drop on us.
I know the fuck I'm doing.
Stealthy is...
You know that house we've been renting out? Called over there last night. Told them I wanted to sell it. Told them they needed to be out in 2 weeks. And the man, his name's John, starts laying into me. Saying the lease gives them the right to a 30-day notice. That's how we supposed to find a new place in 2 weeks. So I tell him none of that's my goddamn problem.
Cool.
Come on, we need to get this vault open. Lincoln, get over here, man.
Oh, I hope this combination skeletor got us is legit.
The graphics. Look at it. Looks so beautiful. Look at this guy.
Well, I'll be damned. All right, go for it, Godzilla.
The money, the gold.
Shit. It's beautiful. All right, I'm gonna take care of this room. You see what you can get from outside. Once these boys punch you with that drill, we're gonna start throwing this down.
Oh, the graphics. Graphics.
God damn it. You triggered the fucking alarm?
Shit, I didn't notice this cage was on a different system.
All right, we're gonna hold off the guards. So Danny's done drilling. Hey, you gonna pull this off.
Okay, everyone. Let's go.
Jesus Christ, it's a fucking robbery! I'll go.
What do you think he's doing? How'd that be a fucker? Oh. Come in! Let the wrong guy bring it!
Got no weapons.
What's he think he's doing?
Reloading! It's a goddamn massacre!
Taking cover!
Come on! Come on.
Damn, we sure kicked the hornet's nest this time.
Only way we walk out of here is if we get the weapons stored in that armory. Bust the door open. I'll watch our asses.
My old man gonna shit a brick when he hears about this. Fuck! Fuck! Come on, open!
Give me that damn thing.
Hit him with the smoke! Shit, man, these guys ain't fucking around.
Face way worse than this over in Nam. Little smoke don't mean shit. Stay close to the vault, watch for the drill. I'll deal with these assholes.
What's he think he's doing?
Gotta be, though!
Well, Sammy had men all over the place. One of them worked at a cleaner's and stole the uniforms Georgie Marcano and Lincoln Clay wore on the day of the robbery. Another one was a janitor at the Federal Reserve, and he provided a rough layout. The robbery of the Federal Reserve was timed perfectly, and none of it would have been possible without the involvement of Sammy Robinson, Lincoln Clay, and the rest of the black mob.
You just come from Vietnam?
That's right.
I was a Marine in the Pacific. You take it from me. Just because you're home doesn't mean you're back. You understand? People around here, they don't get it. Never will. Keep your ass out of trouble.
Yes, sir.
Sorry I'm late. Got caught up crossing the bridge.
Don't worry about it.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for my stepbrother, Lincoln Clay. You seen him? He used to get ticked off if you were even a minute late.
Kiss my ass.
There he is. How was the trip?
Is how this is the first time in 4 years and somebody telling me where to go, what to do, or how to do it? It was fucking great. What's new with the old man?
Man, don't even get me started on Pops. He used to pull his head out of his ass.
Same as ever then.
Brother, you have no fucking idea.
Damn, Ellis. She's looking good. Just like I left her.
Man, even I know not to fuck around with your cop.
All right, come on. I'm ready to go home. Sammy's doing all right.
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes? What if the train's delayed? What if they call him back? And he goes stand in front of the kitchen window and sip his whiskey like he was expecting you to come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you that.
I won't.
Damn, you're scratching the paint.
Where was I? But he fine once he sees you. Ever since Mama Hell, you know how he gets.
Remember Mommy and Ron Langford?
Sure.
They moved up to Empire Bay a year or so after you shipped out. Started selling weed. They call and ask me if I want some. I say, sure. It's free money as far as I'm concerned. Anyhow, a month back, Marty drops me a line that says they're moving into heroin, that they're looking for a partner down around these parts.
Can't imagine Sammy was too keen on that.
I never told him about the weed. That ain't nothing to nobody. But this, I gotta talk to him about. I ain't said more than three words and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with kids running around the neighborhood. We ain't selling no dope to no children.
Like they got any money to begin with. Fucking around aside, heroin was pretty serious shit. Knew a couple guys over in Nam who were running it. Wound up pissing off the wrong person. Got their throats cut.
Shit, man, I know what's what. That's why I'm talking to Georgie about it.
No way Sal's gonna go along with that.
Georgie says he can keep his old man from fighting out. We'll still clear the hollow with Frisco, just selling the French wall. George's Uncle Lou won't say shit as long as we give him a taste of the action.
I don't know, man. Georgie's a cool cat and all, but heroin ain't the kiddie pool.
Come in on it with us. I bet he'd agree to a three-way split.
I don't know. I kind of need to lay low a bit.
Hey, man, be careful! Get us the fuck out of here!
Oh my god.
All units, we have reports of the suspect being sighted in the bayou.
Fuck, that's a hit cop. Oh.
Yo, bad influence, big brother!
Begin searching immediately.
Yeah, anyway. I don't know. I kind of need to lay low a bit, figure some things out.
Yeah, all right. Fuck it, it's your car. Bash it up all you want. Come on, we're going through the front. I ain't having your wall here or I ask you to back out. Look who I found panhandling out in front of the train station.
Pleasure, man.
Welcome back, baby.
Boy, I send you to bring Link on Clayhorn. Not the big nigga with him.
Well, shit, old man. I finally went somewhere they knew how to cook.
Welcome home, son.
How are you? I'll be better once I get some of that shine in me.
I always did love corn whiskey. I would like to make a toast. My father used to say that the real worth of a man came from the mark he left on the world. When Lincoln first told me he was joining the military, I was against it. Too dangerous, I say. Let those people fight their own war, I say. But then I realized Lincoln needed to go out and make his mark. And that's precisely what he did. I'm so proud of you. Paul Lincoln, bienvenue à la maison.
Paul Lincoln, bienvenue à la maison.
Good to see you.
You look so good.
Not seeing you, Lincoln. Oh, I kept you in my prayers.
I really appreciate that, Father.
Now who wants to get shit-faced?
It's hard to explain what it's like coming home from war. Elation, fear, guilt.
Wow.
Imagine being trapped in a dark room and there's no way out. And every fear, every nightmare you ever had is in that room with you. And there's no escape from any of it. And then one day, a door opens and you're free to go. Just like that. The thing is, you made your peace with your terror and your fear of death. And now part of you is afraid to leave it behind. But what choice do you have? Every soldier has to walk through that door, one way or another.
Man, whiskey's going hoy in the morning.
Hell, man, just sleep it off. The room's the same as left it.
I'm gonna take the basement.
The basement? Why the fuck you want to crash down there?
I'll see you in the morning.
Man, that wall's gonna really fuck you up.
Yeah, we got a bed off. Well, no, the bed off. What's this? Ah, my boy. Thank you for the video. Well done, 33 minutes. Being for the story. My video is coming out tomorrow, and a lot of videos are coming out. And will be coming out in a couple days. This is good. I'll see you in the next video, everyone. Bye, have a great day.